Hi, and welcome to this installment of Frank and Mary here in Hudson. For those of you who haven't seen the show before, my name is Art Bergeron. I'm an attorney at Myrick O'Connell. There are 70 of us, about 40 in Worcester and 20 in Westboro, where I spend most of my time, and 10 in Boston. Because we're a multi-specialty firm, everybody gets to do what they like. I like elder law. This show, as you know, if you've watched before, is not about elder law. It's about my friends Frank and Mary. And my imaginary couple who want to live in their house until they die and be buried in the backyard. And as you know, if you're Frank and Mary living in Hudson, you don't want to be buried anyplace else. You don't want to go to San Diego or even to Boston or to go with your kids. Chances are you want to stay here because this is where your friends are, right? This is where you went to high school or grammar school or whatever. And you want to stay here. So the question really is, who do you need to know and what are the programs that you need to know about in order to stay here for the rest of your life? Now, with me isn't right now Jackie Kapopoulos, my wonderful co-host, who is the chair of the Friends of the Hudson Seniors. And the reason is because I screwed up, because Holly Richardson, whom I'm going to introduce, our wonderful guest, had mentioned that she was hoping to be able to leave early because she's got family stuff that she's got to do. And I scheduled it all and hadn't called Jackie. So I realized when I got here that I called Jackie about 15 minutes ago and said, if you come in late and we're already going, we'll just bring you right onto the show. But in the meantime, we're going to start. So Holly Richardson is here today from the Hudson Senior Center.
Yes.
Right? And I just found out when we were talking, right, that we were walking through the door to get into the school. You were like, whoa, this isn't like when I was here, right? There were locks and all this stuff, right? So you went to Hudson?
I did, yeah.
Yeah, you're born and raised here?
Mm-hmm.
And you're now married, and do you still live in Hudson?
I'm in Hudson, yeah.
That's very exciting. Yeah. And so how did you end up doing this? What did, you know, you obviously went to school and stuff and blah, blah, blah. And you go to school like in Massachusetts?
So I ended up working at Worcester Elder Services, and then I ended up transitioning to the Hudson Senior Center. It was just kind of the right time, right job, and it kind of all fell into place.
But that's really great. Worcester Elder Services. Mm-hmm. That's the Worcester equivalent of, I know many of the people have heard of BayPath.
Yep.
Elder Services, which, you know, so Worcester Elder Services also is the aging services access point, the regional entity.
Yeah, for that location,
and it covers,
around Worcester.
I see, and it covers Worcester and some of the towns like around Worcester.
Yeah. Yep.
So that must have been even kind of an interesting transition from that very big organization to something smaller, right?
It's a lot different in terms of even the job. So, I mean, we didn't do insurance for case management. It was home care services, just case management in general.
Yeah, you were going out, but a lot of home visits. With a lot of people.
Yeah, and so now at the senior center, we do all of that. We do case management. We do home visits.
You do home visits too?
Yep. If someone's not able to come to the center, or they're homebound, and they want to get information, we've done home visits for people.
I never knew that.
Yep.
So that's really handy.
Yeah.
That's really, really handy.
Yeah.
And so, and I know one of the reasons why Janice Long asked if you could come on. Mm-hmm. Today was really to talk about Medicare and the Medicare programs because it's enrollment time, right?
Yes. Yep.
But you're telling me you really do a whole variety of things other than that.
Yep. So
can you just give a snapshot of what that is?
Sure. Yeah. So there's two of us outreach workers, myself and then Anna. She's bilingual. She speaks Portuguese.
Yeah.
And we both do assistance with applications, fuel assistance, food stamps. Prescription advantage applications, which is related to Medicare and all of that. We also do just regular case management. We do referrals for home care services, just general information referral, all sorts of programs. And then, of course, we're Shine trained, so we assist with Medicare.
So you do referrals to various home care agencies and stuff?
Yep, to BayPath, or if someone doesn't qualify for BayPath Elder Services and they want a private pay, we have a list of home care agencies that we can provide to them. Then also assisted livings. We visit assisted livings, regularly.
Oh.
When new ones open, we try to go see them. So then that way we can tell our clients the information about the facilities that they might show interest in.
And I suppose that's one of the advantages that folks would have talking to you, because you're dealing with pretty regularly all of those different the home care agencies, as well as the assisted livings. Mm-hmm. So you've actually seen them.
We have. We usually go and visit. Of course, we can't recommend one agency over another. Right. And for assisted livings, it's truly kind of the right fit for the person. They really have to go and visit, you know, see what works for them. Yep. But when we're talking about the facility, we at least like to have a bit of a background on what we're telling them.
And you know, it's funny, I always tell people, doing assisted living, so it's like going to college, you know. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, you tell your kids, go see a whole bunch, and you're going to get one.
You'll know when you get there.
And you just know.
Yeah.
And it just varies. So it isn't like, oh, no, this is the great one.
Yeah.
It's like the question is, like, what really fits for you.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, exactly.
So you do a whole bunch of other stuff. But then your really busy season is right now.
Right? So right now we're doing the Medicare open enrollment. It's October 15th through December 7th.
October 15th through December 7th. So people who are going to see this show, because the show will probably be up next week, are still going to have time.
They do. So don't wait to call, because we are very, we are very booked.
Yeah.
So we do still have availability, though, for people who call in.
And what do you do if someone wants to? What do you do?
So if someone
calls in,
so we try to get some basic information of what type of insurance that you have, and we'll tell you to come in and bring your list of medications, the name, the dosage, the frequency of the medication, your Medicare card, a list of your doctors, and so we try to have all of that. So we have you come in and we'll review what your drug list is. Are you in the best plan for you? Are you, you know, some people haven't had their insurance reviewed for years, and then they find that they can save themselves hundreds, a few thousand, you know, depending on that. So it's a really good idea to have it reviewed every year.
And you can literally do that, right? Yep. That's the nice thing about Medicare.
Yep.
And I had known that was true for Medicare D, for the drug plans.
Yep.
And I only found out last year that it's also true for Medicare A, B, and C, for the Medicare plans and the Advantage plan.
Yeah.
You can literally switch every year depending on whether your health has changed.
Yeah, right? So Medicare A and B is just, you know, your hospital insurance and then your medical insurance. But Medicare A and B doesn't cover everything. So there's a lot of gaps in coverage, which is why people typically end up supplementing their Medicare. And they can do that in two different ways. They can do a Medicare Advantage plan, which is also known as Part C.
Mm-hmm.
Those are your HMOs, your PPOs. That's where everything is kind of in one policy.
Mm-hmm.
You are in a network of doctors. You have referrals. You pay co-payments when you go to the doctors.
Yep.
And then, of course, there's Medigaps, which is called, it's a true supplement. It supplements your Medicare A and B. It does not cover prescriptions, though, so you do need to get a separate standalone drug plan.
So,
and so that's where Part D would be.
I see. So you're either doing A, B, and D.
A, B, a supplement in D.
And, or you're doing C.
C, and the Part C manages your A and B, but it also incorporates your drug coverage.
So the Medicare Advantage plans, they do all of the things that A and B does.
It manages
But they also have it. They also incorporate a drug plan.
Coverage. Yeah.
And so can we just talk about those plans for a couple of minutes,
sure.
And then I want to go back to D's, because I know that's kind of the most common reason why people would call you, is because they're trying to figure out, they're on A and B and they want to figure out what D is going to be.
We have everyone call in about basically everything. Even for Advantage plans, we have people call in because, you know, sometimes they'll find that their co-payments are getting a little bit too high, or they find that their health is kind of declining, and so they're going to see more doctors. They might be paying more out of pocket than they expected to, or they did the year prior.
I see.
So they might want to change their policy, or, you know, maybe they took a lesser premium plan at one point because they were really healthy, they didn't go to the doctors, and maybe they want to just increase their coverage so they don't have to pay as much in co-payments.
And that's the key for folks to understand, right?
Yeah.
Is that you may have been healthy
at one point,
and therefore you assumed, well, you know, I'll take the chance regarding the co-payments, so I'd rather, and I'm going to take a low premium instead.
Yeah.
But the wonderfulness of the Medicare Advantage plans is that every year you can do it over. You can kind of say to yourself, literally, I might have some problems next year, and therefore I'm going to enroll.
Mm-hmm.
Now, can you literally, like even, so for example, suppose I found I had cancer, right? And I just found out. And I knew that I was going to be going through a lot of chemotherapy and stuff next year. Yeah. Can I literally just still switch plans right now?
You can switch right now without any special enrollment right now, because open enrollment is, you can make a change regardless of the reason, which is October 15th through December 7th. And then in addition to that, we always tell people to call in if they have a change in circumstances, even if it is in the middle of the year, because there may be a special enrollment period for them that they may be able to change their plan in the middle of the year.
I didn't know you could ever do that.
And there are certain qualifying reasons that you can do it. You know, we have a list of things that you would have to qualify for. Yeah. You know, it could be that there's a you have prescription advantage, which allows you a once opportunity to make a change to your policy outside of the open enrollment period. If you qualify for extra help, you can change your plan quarterly.
Yeah.
It could be that you're enrolling into a five-star plan. Anyone has an opportunity to enroll into a five-star plan.
What is a five-star plan?
It's just simply the rating, what the plans have been rated. So there's Tufts was a five-star plan this year, and then Blue Cross Blue Shield drug plans were. So anyone who has an opportunity to enroll into a five-star plan once outside of the open enrollment period.
I see.
And then, of course,
are those only drug plans, or are those Medicare Advantage
plans? So those are drug plans and Medicare Advantage plans. Yeah. And then, of course, Prescription Advantage can help people enroll into another drug plan if they need to. You know, Prescription Advantage helps when they reach the donut hole. But it
okay,
also,
so let's talk about, let's go, yeah. let's go to drugs for,
sure.
we'll talk about drugs for a while.
Okay.
But by the way, no, just before we go to drugs, so how does anybody figure that this out? You know, the Medicare Advantage, other than folk going to you, who else could they talk to? Because I wouldn't think that they're... For certainly, I don't understand it. Well, I'm trying to figure it out right now, as it happens, right? So I'm going to be turning 70 in January, and so but my wife just retired, so we're trying to figure out, you know, the standard stuff, you know. So how does the amount that I'm paying as part of my employer plan compare to what, in this case, both of our Medicare payments would be if we were trying to do this?
And we can help you. We can help you do that, because sometimes with employer plans, you do have a deductible that you have to meet.
Yeah.
So we always tell people to take that into consideration, you know, but it all depends on how much you're spending for your employer plan versus how much it would be on Medicare. But we can help you go over that and kind of compare the costs.
And you're doing it across all those Medicare plans. Okay, so now let's talk a little bit about Medicare, so-called Medicare D, right? The famous drug plans.
Yeah.
One of the things that you had just mentioned was, you know, you have to evaluate the plan to decide what's the best plan for you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Talk about that. Talk about the what would for that your what would go into your decision making to try to figure that out.
So that's whenever someone comes in to have their information reviewed, we do ask about getting a list of their prescriptions. So we do put it on the Medicare website, and that would generate the best possible drug plan or Advantage plan. If they're looking for that, we can tell them how much their prescriptions would cost for them.
So there's a website where you actually can, which has just the list.
It's the Medicare website.
And it literally has all the drugs.
Yep.
All
so
the drugs
what we would
on.
Do is we would enter your prescriptions in. It would give us a drug list, and then the Medicare website would generate the top plans. It would give you the information about the pricing, the tier of your medication, what you would end up spending.
About the tier of your medication, what does that mean?
So each medication that you have, it's classified as a certain tier. So it could be a tier one, a tier two, a tier three, four, five. And some plans are even offering tier six, depending on the plan.
And what is that based on? Is that based on the price of the medication?
It's not. So, and that's the other thing too, is that tiers of medication can change and they can vary from plan to plan. You know, I might be on a tier one generic medication and it's a tier one on one plan, but on another plan, it could be classified as a tier two. So your medication can be classified as a different tier per plan as well, which means that it would be a different cost.
Oh my
per
God.
Plan.
So does tier one kind of mean like generics?
Yeah, is that tier one is usually the preferred generics. Tier two is usually like a non-preferred generic. Tier three and four is usually a brand. And then tier five and six is usually like a specialty medication.
So a non-preferred generic, that's a generic that this particular drug plan is saying, we're charging you more on that because that's not preferred.
It's kind of hard to say, you know, because each, like I said, each plan is the one that sets what the tier is.
Yeah.
And it doesn't mean that it's necessarily a non-preferred brand. It could be a generic medication, but it's going to be classified as a brand.
Yeah.
But how they determine that, I don't really know.
So you've been doing this now for quite a few years,
yeah.
right? So in your experience, year to year, do the individual plans change substantially from year to year?
Sometimes they do, and it's yep. some plans are also bought out, or they're you know, consumed
out.
By another company, and so your plan might stay the same, but it might have a different name, and so you'll get a new card in the mail. So,
I see.
So yeah, and sometimes plans, you know, they're eliminated, and so you're auto-enrolled into a different plan. And they
can plans be eliminated in the course of a year?
Not in the middle of a year.
Oh, I see, but when you're going mm-hmm. to re-enroll.
But like for enrollment, yeah. We've had a few plans that they're no longer available this year, and so they yeah. were auto-enrolled into a new plan for next year. But just because you are auto-enrolled into another plan doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be the exact same coverage that you had with the plan that you previously had.
I get it.
So it's really important to have it reviewed.
And for if I'm just going along and I've got a plan right now and then comes December and I didn't do anything, if I do nothing, does the old plan automatically auto-enroll?
So that depends on whether or not your plan is changing. If it was bought out from another company or if it was consumed by another company, then yeah. you would just get a new card in the mail from yeah. whatever the new company was.
Yeah.
But if you have a plan that they're not changing at all, if you didn't do anything to your coverage, if you didn't have it reviewed, then it would just stay the exact same. You wouldn't have to re-enroll or anything yeah. like that. It would just continue as it has been.
So when you do this analysis, so I walk in mm-hmm. with my wife and we're kind of talking yeah. to you, right? And we give you our drug list.
Mm-hmm.
And so what does your analysis look like? Do you basically say, okay, so here's the premium, mm-hmm. right? And then we'll make some assumptions about, well, I suppose from your drug mm-hmm. list also, it would say prescriptions so many per week or so much per, so you could actually do an estimate of how much the
buying. Yeah, they'll tell us how much, you know, what we would do is you'd come in, you tell us, I take this medication once a day, so we
yep.
put in the quantity for the month.
Yep.
And then the Medicare website would give us the pricing information for how much it would cost you for the month. And then we also look at it in terms of an overall year cost. You know, and we want to make sure. And then also the pharmacy that you're going to can make a difference as well if you're going to a preferred pharmacy for that plan.
Oh,
so
in addition to the drug list,
yeah.
there's a pharmacy list.
Yep, so sometimes there are preferred pharmacies for certain drug plans where if you go to a preferred pharmacy, you'll get preferred pricing, so you might be paying a little bit less money.
Right.
Or if you go to a non-preferred pharmacy, you might be spending more money. And it could be significant, you know, savings just by switching pharmacies sometimes.
That's amazing too, and I never would have known any of that.
Yeah.
So the bottom line is, this is the one time when you can really kind of go through
yeah.
all of this stuff.
And then, like I said, there are special enrollment periods that people can make a change to their plan if they qualify for a special enrollment period.
Yeah.
We do have a list of what they're called a SEP, S-E-P, special enrollment period.
Yeah.
And we could meet with you and say whether or not you qualify for a SEP to make a change to your plan if you've somehow forgot about the open enrollment period. There's also yep. a new period of time. It's in January. It's for anyone who's on a Medicare Advantage plan.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the Medicare Advantage open enrollment period. It used to be called the disenrollment period. And it was for anyone who was on a Medicare Advantage plan.
Mm-hmm.
They could disenroll from their plan, go back to original Medicare, enroll into a drug plan. But now, during the Medicare Advantage open enrollment period, people can have their stuff reviewed during that time.
Mm-hmm.
They could go back to original Medicare, enroll mm-hmm. into a drug plan, enroll into a supplement, because that is continuous open enrollment.
Yeah.
Or they can also make a change to another Medicare Advantage plan during that time.
So they can do everything.
During that time, only if you have a Medicare Advantage plan, though, at
I
that
see.
Point. That,
I see.
That specific time is specific for Medicare Advantage.
So it's like
plans.
A special consumer option that's available for people who are in, because the Medicare mm-hmm. Advantage plans are all run by the private sector, by various insurance companies.
Yeah,
right?
That would be even for supplements and for drug plans. They're all private.
They're all private.
Yeah.
But specifically for the Advantage plans.
For Advantage plans.
So you could switch. You could pick anything right now, right, as an advantage plan until, is that the same drop dead date as for the drug plans, December 8th?
So December 7th is the December 7th is the last day that anyone can make a change to their plan, regardless of the reason. It's just the open enrollment period. They can make a change until December 7th.
Yeah.
And then if you have a Medicare Advantage plan, then you do qualify for that Medicare Advantage open enrollment period, which would start in January.
So there's got to be, I remember seeing this list, there have got to be 2,000 people in Hudson over the age of 70. Mm-hmm. How many people do you see? How many people will you have seen to talk about this stuff between, say, September 1 and when you're done here, the end of the year?
Well, we can't make any changes for people in terms of reviewing their plan until October 15th. And so, we actually don't even get the information for the plans until really a couple of days before.
And the way that you find out about all the plans is?
We have training that we go to with our regional SHINE director.
I see.
And they relay all the information to us.
I see. So you don't actually get presentations made to you by the drug company or by the insurers?
No.
I get it. But it's very, very soon before you're actually starting to talk to people. So it's really from October 15th
December 7th.
So it's a little less than 2 months. How many people, and when I say people, how many clients, where a client is either an individual or a family, right? Will you see during that period?
I don't know. If you ask Janice, she could tell you the exact number.
No, I don't want an exact. Is it like 100? Is it like 1,000?
I would say roughly, it's in the hundreds that we would see. Yeah.
It is.
But it's in addition to myself, it's also Janice and Anna. We're all SHINE trained, so we can.
So you all do this?
Yes.
Wow. That must be kind of just all consuming for this period of time.
It's very busy.
And can a person, can only people come to you who are from Hudson?
Usually we recommend people to see their SHINE counselor in their town if they're from a town that actually has a counselor there.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought that all communities had SHINE counselors.
So some towns, they have maybe someone that goes in like once. It could be once a week. And so their availability.
Oh, so it's like a volunteer.
Yeah. So they may not have available options for them to go see them. So we have accepted people from outside of Hudson. Yes.
I see.
Yeah.
So is it typical? Now, once again, when you talk, I was kind of surprised when you said originally that you were doing all of that stuff, because my experience was that in a lot of towns, they're just volunteers that do this stuff.
For the SHINE program.
Yeah.
It is volunteers. There are some senior centers, though, that their staff is trained as SHINE counselors.
Right.
And then we, of course, at the Hudson Senior Center, we're all trained.
And that's got to be an advantage because you just have more staff power to be able to kind of go through this stuff with these people, right?
We're able to see a lot of people.
But
like I said, all other senior centers, they take on a lot of people as well. And we always recommend, to call early in the season to make sure that you can be seen.
So just now one more question. This is going to be, I'm saying this is for me, but it's really for everybody in my group. So I'm not retired yet. And I'm not retired, but I'm not on Medicare.
Yeah.
Right, because I could still be on Medicare and not be retired. Mm-hmm. So I'm on a company plan, right? So when I stop at the company, it seems to me they told me that I've got some period of time from that date.
You do.
To go on to Medicare.
Yep.
Right? And that is how long?
So we do intro to Medicare regularly, so throughout the year. So anyone who is retiring or they're turning 65 and they need to go on Medicare, we do intros all the time.
Oh, you do like classes there?
Not classes. We do one-on-one sessions. So you call in and say that I'm retiring in 2 months. I'm going to need to go on in Medicare.
Right.
Then we'll have you come in and we'll do an introduction to Medicare, go over the basics of it, the different parts, the options, the supplement, and kind of give you a rundown of what your options are.
Yeah.
And we always let the person make their decision of what they think is going to be best for them, because everyone's needs are so different. What might work for you might not work so well for your wife.
Right.
You might have different medical needs, and so you might be on different plans, which is completely fine.
Right. And that's the question, is kind of what does it all add up to at the end?
So we'll do Medicare 101s, have you come in, and then if you are, let's say that you're retiring, you left your employer, you do have a certain amount of time that you can enroll into Medicare.
Right.
There's certain paperwork that you have to get in place that you'd want to bring with you to the Social Security office. And then you have a certain period of time after you've lost your employer coverage to do it. So there's a lot of special enrollment periods, and we want to make sure that you don't miss those deadlines.
So my wife's from Hudson, so it would be okay if I came to see you?
Yeah.
This would be very exciting.
Yeah.
This is really amazing. This is really amazing. So, hear all that, right? It is inconceivable that anybody could figure this out without talking to a person like Holly. I can't imagine it. I consider myself to be a relatively bright person, and I do a lot of stuff involving elder law. I could not possibly understand this without talking to somebody. So the moral of this story is, you gotta go talk to her, right? Now, I know that she's really busy right now, and so I'm sorry, and this is the end of the enrollment period, and so she may not be able to squeeze you in, but I bet she'll try, right? But these are crucial things. In my experience, for a lot of people who are living at home, your medical expenses is second only to either taxes or food as your major expense as a senior. And they can literally figure out how to save you a lot of money. This is a free service, right? And you know, and if they get it wrong, you can always go back and yell at them, right? Because they're right at the senior center all the time, right? You owe it to yourself to do this. This is just really, really important. So Holly Richardson, thank you very much for coming on. I'm so happy that you stayed in Hudson. That's a wonderful thing. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next installment of Frank and Mary here in Hudson. Thanks very much.